This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Poland-Czechoslovakia War, also known mostly in Czech sources as the Seven-Day War (Czech: Sedmidenní válka), was a military confrontation between Czechoslovakia and Poland over the territory of Cizin Silesia in 1919. The Czechoslovak government in Prague requested that the Poles cease their preparations for elections to the Polish Sejm in the area that had been designated Polish in the interim agreement, as no sovereign rule was to be executed in the disputed areas. The Polish government declined, and Czechoslovak units attacked the Polish part of Cizin Silesia to prevent the elections in the contested territory. The attack was halted under pressure from the Entente. The result of the war was the new demarcation line, which expanded the territory controlled by Czechoslovakia. It led to the division of the region of Cizin Silesia in July 1920, and left a substantial Polish minority in Czechoslovakia in the region later called Zaolzie. The division of Cizin Silesia did not satisfy Poland and led to the Polish annexation of Zaolzie in 1938. Contents 1. Background 2. Forces 3. Battle 4. Conclusion 5. See also 6. Footnotes 7. References. Background. During the final months of World War I, Polish and Czechoslovak diplomats met to hammer out a common border between the two new countries. By the time the armistice was declared, most of the border was worked out except for three small politically sensitive areas in Upper Silesia and Upper Hungary, which were claimed by both countries. Cizin Silesia, or the Duchy of Teschen (Polish: Cizin and Czech: Tessin), was a small area in southeastern Silesia. The last Austrian census of 1910 determining nationality according to the main communication language German, Umgangssprache of the respondents showed that it was predominantly Polish-speaking in three districts: Cizin, Bielsko, and Freistadt, and mainly Czech-speaking in the fourth district of Freitag. The city of Cizin itself was mainly German-speaking part of the population. The Slazikowsi claimed a distinct, Silesian identity. The chief importance of Cizin Silesia was the rich coal basin around Karvina and the valuable Kosice-Bohumen railway line, which linked the Czech lands with Slovakia. Furthermore, in northwestern Cizin Silesia, the railroad junction of Bohumen served as a crossroad for international transport and communications. On 5 November 1918, the Polish National Council and the Czechoslovak Committee concluded an agreement on the demarcation line for administrative and military purposes, and divided the area along the ethnic boundaries. The Freitag district and a small part of the Freistadt district was left on the Czech side. The remainder was accorded to the Poles' forces. Czechoslovak legionaries from France in Cizin Silesia, Czechoslovak legionaries from Italy in northwest Slovakia leaving for Cizin Silesia. The Czechoslovak side was led by Joseph Snederek. Czechoslovak military forces had been formed from the three legionary battalions of the 21st Shooting Regiment from France, the 54th Infantry Battalion of Olomouc, the 93rd Infantry Battalion of Freistadt, a volunteer battalion from Bohumen, and a volunteer battalion from Orlova. The operations of the Czechoslovak forces were joined by other local volunteers, formed in the National Guard. Approximately 5,000 men strong from the northwest of Slovakia came the main force that was sent to support the 35th Legionary Regiment from Italy, led by the Italian Colonel Grasselli, and later reinforced with the Shooting Legion Regiment from Italy. During the war, the Czechoslovak army was reinforced by the newly formed 2nd Brigade with a strength of 6 battalions, with the support of 2 artillery batteries, and 1 cavalry squadron. The Czechoslovak army was further strengthened by the 1st Battalion of the 28th Infantry Regiment, 1st BTN of the 3rd Infantry Reg, 2nd BTN of the 93rd Infantry Reg, and 5 volunteer battalions. Polish forces under the command of Franciszek Latnik were weaker than the Czechoslovak forces at the end of World War I. Poland was fighting in border disputes with all its neighbors, and during the war with Czechoslovakia, the main force was committed to the fighting in eastern Galicia with the Ukrainians. The Polish forces were composed of 5 infantry battalions supported by 4 machine gun companies, a cavalry platoon, and an artillery battery. Other forces included approximately 550 members of the Gendarmerie and around 6,500 local Polish volunteers. Polish forces were reinforced during the war. Battle. Main article: Battle of Skoczów on 23 January 1919 at 11 o'clock in Cizin Silesia. Polish commander Franciszek Latnik and Czechoslovak officer Joseph Snederek met with a group of officers, consisting of English, French, Italian and U.S. representatives at the request of the Czechoslovak Party. The Polish side was given an ultimatum, that they evacuate the area to the Biala River in less than 2 hours. After the expiry of this period, the Czechoslovak Army started its operations at 1300 following its operational guidelines to seize Bohumín and Karviná from the east. At the same time, an attack was launched by the Italian Legionnaire unit. The Czechoslovak army moved forward, and took Bohumín at 1600, Orlova and Karviná. Cieszyn Silesia was occupied without a fight. On 27 January 1919 Polish troops retreated to the river Vistula. On 30 January 1919 Joseph Snederek received the order to cross the Vistula and secure the railway line between Bohumín and Jablunkov. They crossed the river and the Polish troops retreated to Skoczów, where the front line was stalled. Further Czechoslovak reinforcements arrived, which gave Snederek an advantage over the Polish units. The Czechoslovak army prepared for an attack on Skoczów, assuming that it would lead to the collapse of the Polish defences on 31 January 1919. Because of the pressure from the Triple Entente representatives, the attack on Skoczów was cancelled, and the Czechoslovak army ceased fighting. The Czechoslovak army withdrew to the new Green Line, established by the International Commission Agreement on the basis of the Czechoslovak-Polish Treaty, concluded on 3 February 1919 in Paris. Conclusion: the disputed territory was placed under international control. The final division of Cieszyn Silesia came in July 1920 as a result of the SPA conference. In conclusion, the railway line connecting the Czech lands with Slovakia and the territory to the south of it were assigned to Czechoslovakia, while the territory north of the railway line was assigned to Poland. In precise terms, Poland was assigned one-third of the population, 142,000 out of 435,000, less than half of the territory, 1,002. Wyboro, Katorbaj Bili Wykazali bez W.S. Zelkiej Prisi I Agitacji, Z Slask Gest Polskim, Karat Zaradnik 1992, 178-179. Karat Ludwig Patron ed. Die Ergebnis der Volksalung vom 31 December 1910 in Schlesien, Trapau 1912. Karat Hannon 1996, 47. Karat Wanditz, Peter S. France and Her Eastern Allies, 1919-1925, French Czechoslovak Polish Relations from the Paris Peace Conference in Locarno, January 1, 1962. Ed. University of Minnesota Press, Minnesota Archive Editions, edition pp. February 3, 1919. Signing in Paris of Polish-Czech Border Agreement on the basis of the November 5, 1918, Ethnic Division Agreement. July 28, 1920. Allied Ambassadors Decision. Partitioning Cieszyn, Silesia, and leaving in Czechoslovakia a quarter of a million Poles in the strategic Moravian Gate. Letting to Poland from the southwest. References. Davies, Norman Polsko-Dziedziny Narodowej Stredu Evropy. Praha. Praha.